Thank you for coming to my virtual recital, where I'm going to be exploring time, how we feel time, and how I feel time. There has never been a point in time where I thought I would start a recital with Abyss of the Birds, but here we are in 2020, and I'm recording a virtual recital. Abyss of the Birds is a movement from the quartet For the End of Time. This piece was originally written when Messiaen was a prisoner of war during World War II. In a German prison camp. This particular movement is an exploration of time. As Messiaen says, the abyss is time with its sadness, its weariness. The birds are the opposite to time. They are our desire for light, for stars, for rainbows, and for jubilant songs. In this particular piece, from the moment I learned it to now, I hear different things. One of the things that I think he really embodies is the stretch of time. This is something that, as a performer, I can really feel. The tempo markings for this piece are extremely slow. I can also hear the birds and their objection to the stretch of time. I can feel the restlessness for something to change, the inner rage of sadness and endlessness, church bells indicating that it's time for something to happen, and the churning anxiety of feeling time pass slowly. Messiaen said of the premiere, "Never was I listened to with such rapt attention and comprehension." I think in times of stress, in times of war, it is remarkable that the human drive to create and consume art is so strong. At the beginning of this pandemic, when we were locked away, it wasn't like a vacation. We were all so anxious, and we weren't sure when anything was going to end. In fact, we still aren't. However, I have never witnessed such a burst of creative output from everyone, from professionals to amateurs. And there is something distinctly human about how we turn to creativity and how we consume art when we have the time. I hope as you listen to this piece that you're able to feel the endless, weary time, but also that you hear the desire buried in there for light, for stars, for rainbows, and for jubilant songs.
Thank you.
This next collection of pieces are actually transcriptions of recordings from three different musical traditions in three different cultures. For me, recordings are such a unique way to preserve time. They are an attempt to capture a moment, so that moment can be recreated over and over again. A moment in time very literally serving as a record of events. However, as we come back to visit these moments, the experiences and time we are currently in change how that moment felt. We can never truly completely capture the authenticity of a moment through a recording. Even with this recital, as I listen back to what I did weeks ago, my feelings and perceptions have changed. Therefore, that recorded moment is forever evolving and will never be the same. There are several things I considered when approaching these transcriptions. The first is that these cultures and this music is not mine. These pieces are a way for a curious musician to stretch their abilities on their sounds and sonority that I can create with a clarinet and challenge myself with different feelings of time, because not all music everywhere feels time the way I do. And because this music is not mine, these recordings are not and will never be monetized. The next thing to consider is authenticity. As I mentioned before, the authenticity of a recorded moment is tainted the second we move away from that point in time. However, I also did not approach these pieces in an effort to provide an authentic performance of this music. Though clarinet is found in musical traditions all over the world, it is not found in these particular traditions. These traditions are also rich and full of nuance that I couldn't possibly begin to learn from one performance and one learning of these pieces. Again, these are transcriptions of a recording and a recording of these transcriptions. This was a personal challenge and an introduction for me to get these musical traditions in my ear. I began watching live stream events constantly from people in Bali performing this kind of music, and it was invigorating to be a respectful observer and appreciator of this music. Finally, for me, identifying my lenses was really important for me to consider when presenting these pieces. Not only am I a Western classically trained clarinetist, these pieces are being performed in a concert hall in an academic building. There are times I can hear myself trying to swell like an orchestral clarinetist in places that I should not, because that's how I've been taught. Again, it's a recording of a transcription of a recording. These filters of these experiences of these pieces have gone through so many changes in order for me to present them to you. So it's really important to recognize the lens that I am coming through and presenting these pieces through. In addition to all of that, I've created a link to the original recordings and notes from the transcriber, and I'll put those in the comments. When this recital is converted onto YouTube, these things will be found in the description. If I was unable to locate the original recording, I provided links to the group that recorded the pieces or provided links to some of the most accomplished people in these styles and traditions. These pieces have really allowed me to stretch my technique and the sounds the clarinet can make. It's been a joy to even get to try to perform these styles of music. I really hope you enjoy them. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for joining me in this virtual recital about time. The last piece that I'm going to be doing is called Fünf Grotesken, which roughly translates to five grotesque pieces. These five strange little pieces are absolutely incredible. I think while the other two pieces, they're outward presentations of time, with Abyss, we thought about the stretch of time and when things are happening and feeling the anxiety of time. And then in the last piece, we talked about the recordings and how they're moments in time that are used to visit over and over again. And so the audience can outwardly understand that. But this particular piece is just how I feel the time. And this is only visible to the performer. So most of these movements have no time signature, which means that there is no guide to when things should happen and what should get the beat. Some of the movements have 2 to 4 time signatures that follow no pattern. So the real challenge for me with these pieces was deciding when everything was supposed to happen. I find myself getting into inner arguments and changing my mind constantly about how things were supposed to go and what order and what notes belong to what. So to the audience, these are spooky, grotesque, sometimes melancholy and deranged character pieces, perfect for Halloween. However, for me, it was much more than that. It was truly trying to decipher how the time was going to pass. I sincerely hope that you enjoy these pieces as much as I do. Thank you so much for joining me with this musical virtual journey of time.